Hello there! In this video, we're going to show you how to paint the trim that appears on the robes of the Dark Angels. This is a really fun bit of extra detail to do for your Dark Angels. The tips and techniques that we'll show you can easily be used on other models in your collection. The paints we'll be using are on the screen right now. We also have a list of the additional equipment we've used, but you can use whatever brushes you feel most comfortable with. If you're new to painting or want to brush up on your skills, you can check out the Citadel Color Painting Essentials videos to learn all about our paints and painting techniques. As you can see, we'll be using our Asthma Dye Master of Repentance that we painted in a previous video. Let's get painting. We're going to use White Scar to do our trim on the green robes first. We're using a small layer here for control, but feel free to use whatever brush you like. We want the paint to flow nice and smoothly off our brush, so we're going to thin it out in order to make it not too thick and goopy. This will help us if we make a mistake, as it'll be easier to tidy up and thus not add any unwanted texturing. This can be tricky and does require some practice, so if you're not feeling confident, it's a good idea to try on your palette first. I've put some Caliban Green onto the palette for me to paint on, so you can see my practice lines. When doing the trim, or thin lines in general, don't apply too much pressure through the brush, as this will cause more paint to come off the bristles and onto the surface. Hold your brush nice and lightly, and this will allow you to control your lines. As you can see, we've angled the model so that we are painting downwards towards ourselves. This allows us to maintain maximum control of where we want the paint to be. In general, it is much harder to paint upwards and away from yourself. We're going to do the trim first and then come back to do the triangles. When doing the triangles, we're going to map out where we want them first, so we're looking to do some evenly spaced lines along our trim. Once that is done, we'll paint the bottom line on the triangle to give us our width. When that's done, we'll then paint the connecting lines from the apex to the bottom points. Finally, all that's left to do is paint the area of the triangle. Remember to keep the paint nice and thin here and build it up with a few coats, as we don't want any texturing. This is a time-consuming extra stage, but little details like this can really bring the model to life. For the green lines on the cream robe, we'll use Caliban Green. We're going to repeat the exact process that we did with the white trim. We have to reiterate that this is definitely an extra bit of detail for your model. It's not something that you have to do at all. It is also a technique that will take a lot of practice to do, so if it's something that you want to do, try, and try again. Keep practicing and working on your brush control, and you will see the results. Take your time when doing this and enjoy the process. And there we go, our Dark Angels trim is complete and has really brought our miniature to life. We've had a lot of fun with this video, and we hope that it's given you the inspiration to try out doing something that might be out of your comfort zone. For more tutorials, tips and tricks, check out our videos on the Warhammer YouTube channel, or you can head to your local Warhammer store where our amazing staff will be more than happy to help. Well, we hope you've enjoyed this video and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.